Hello everybody, this is Ashray here, and today I'm going to be dealing with the topic anatomy of the breast, and I'll be dealing with it under the further subheadings: introduction, local relation, structure, blood supply, lymphatic drainage, nerve supply, and development of the breast. Firstly, introduction. And why I chose this topic, because from our first year till we finish our MBBS as well as in our entrance exam, this is a very tested topic. So this is a very important topic, and the most basic point I'm going to be starting with is breast is nothing but modified sweat gland, and the function in males, it is nothing but a rudimentary organ, and in females it serves as a very important accessory organ of the female reproductive system, because it provides nutrition in the form of milk to the newborn. So it's a very, very important accessory organ of the female reproductive system. Now coming to the local anatomy, where firstly, where is the breast situated? It is situated in the pectoral region of our body, and it lies over the superficial fascia. And the breast is divided into four quadrants, that is the upper lateral quadrant, upper medial quadrant, lower medial quadrant, and the lower lateral quadrant. And there is a small extension of the breast that is nothing but the axillary tail of Spence. This is from the upper lateral part of the breast, and this extension goes through something called as the foramen of Langer and lies in the deep fascia. Now coming to the extent of the breast, vertically the breast extends from the second rib to the sixth rib, and horizontally the breast extends from the lateral border of manubrium sterni, lateral border of the manubrium sterni, to the anterior axillary fold. Now coming to the deeper relations of the breast. Now below the breast is the pectoral fascia. And below the pectoral fascia, the breast lies over three muscles. From top to bottom, it lies over the pectoralis major muscle. And below it is the external oblique muscle and the serratus anterior muscle, and then external oblique muscle. So the breast lies over pectoralis major, serratus anterior, and the external oblique muscle. And there is a space between the breast and the pectoral fascia, and this is called as the retromammary space. Why this retromammary space is important is that it connects, the content of the retromammary space is loose areolar tissue, and this helps in the free movement of the breast over the pectoralis major muscle, and so the breast is just not attached and it is freely movable over the pectoralis major muscle. Now let's come to the structure of the breast. We can study the structure of the breast under three topics: skin, parenchyma, and the stroma. Firstly, the skin. Firstly, we see nipple. This nipple is nothing but a conical projection, as we see over here, conical projection, and this nipple is pierced by 15 to 20 lactiferous ducts. This breast is pierced by 15 to 20 lactiferous ducts, and it is rich in nerve supply and has many sensory organs at the termination of the nerve fibers. Now coming to the areola. This areola is nothing but the skin surrounding the nipple is nothing but areola, as we see over here. Nipple, areola. The skin surrounding the nipple is the areola, and this areola contains many number of modified sweat glands, and these modified sweat glands during the time of pregnancy, they become hypertrophied, and they are called as the Montgomery glands, nothing but they are called as the Montgomery tubercles or the Montgomery glands. And below the areola lies the lactiferous sinus, as we see over here. Below the areola lies the lactiferous sinus, and this is the place where the milk is stored. Now coming to the parenchyma. So the breast is mainly composed of compound tubular alveolar glands. So firstly, we can divide the breast into 15 to 20 lobes. As we see over here, there are 15 to 20 lobes over in the breast. Now each lobe contains many alveoli. As we see in this picture, the breast contains many alveoli. Alveoli is the place where the milk is secreted. From the alveoli, the milk is drained into the lactiferous duct. As we see over here, this is the lactiferous duct. From the lactiferous duct, the milk is drained into the lactiferous sinus and the milk is stored over here. Finally, once the baby sucks out the milk through the nipple, it is drained into the nipple and further into the mouth of the baby. Coming to the histology. Alveolar epithelium. Histology. Alveolar epithelium, during the resting phase, that is from the puberty till the mother becomes pregnant, it is lined by cuboidal epithelium. And once the pregnancy starts, the breast starts getting hypertrophied and the alveoli and the alveoli epithelium is lined by columnar epithelium and secretion of milk starts, nothing but lactation. The ducts, coming to the ducts, the smaller ducts are lined by the columnar epithelium. Larger ducts are lined by two or more layers of the same columnar epithelium, and the terminal part of the breast duct is lined by stratified squamous keratinized epithelium. And throughout the alveoli and duct, we find something called as myoepithelial sites. And these myoepithelial sites are the one which help in the drainage of the milk from lactiferous ducts to the nipple. The contraction of these myoepithelial sites helps in the drainage of the breast. Coming to the stroma now, stroma forms the supportive part of the breast. It contains both fibrous and as well as the fatty stroma. Now the fibrous stroma forms the septae, and these septae are called as the suspensory ligament of Cooper, as we see in this figure. Suspensory ligament of Cooper, or in this figure we find suspensory ligament of Cooper. This one. These suspensory ligament of Cooper help the breast, help the skin and the gland of the breast to be attached to the pectoralis fascia. And the fatty stroma forms the male. This fatty stroma, it forms the main bulk of the gland. As we see in this histological picture, in the inactive phase, we find very few glands and large amount of stroma. This is the fire. We find the fibrous stroma over here, and we find the fatty stroma. But once during the pregnancy, the glands proliferate and glands occupy maximum part of the breast tissue, as we see in this histological picture. Now we finish with the structure. Coming to the blood supply. As we know, breast is a very extremely vascular organ. Coming to the arterial supply, firstly, it is supplied by the perforating branch of the internal thoracic artery. This internal thoracic artery is nothing but a branch of the subclavian artery. Secondly, it's supplied by the superior thoracic artery, acromiothoracic artery and the lateral thoracic artery. These are all the branches of the axillary artery. The superior thoracic artery comes from the first part of the axillary artery. And the acromiothoracic and the lateral thoracic artery comes from the second part of the axillary artery. And thirdly, it is supplied by the branches from posterior intercostal arteries, as we see over here. Coming to the venous drainage. All of the venous blood come and converge towards the base of the nipple. Over here, it forms an anastomotic channel. Further, these anastomotic channels are divided into superficial and deep branches. The superficial branch drains into the internal thoracic vein, and the deep branch drains into the axillary and posterior intercostal vein. Now, after the blood supply, we'll read about the lymphatic drainage. And this is the most important topic we are going to study, as the CA breast spreads mostly along the lymphatics to the regional lymph nodes. And for a surgeon, this becomes very, very important during the dissection of the breast. During the resection of the breast. And as well as in our entrance exam, or in our fourth year exam, this is a very, very important topic. So we shall study on the two headings, lymph nodes and the lymphatic vessels. Lymph nodes, there are two groups. One is the axillary lymph nodes. This about 75% of the lymphatics from the breast drain to the axillary lymph nodes. These axillary lymph nodes, there are six groups of axillary lymph nodes. Firstly, the anterior or the pectoral group of lymph nodes. They lie along the lateral thoracic vein. They lie along the lateral thoracic vein. And this drains, the major part of the breast drains into the anterior group of lymph nodes. It also drains the upper half of the anterior wall of the trunk, also drains into the anterior group of lymph nodes. Second is the lateral or humeral group of lymph nodes. They lie along the posterior medial part of the axillary vein. Along the head of the humerus, they lie along the posterior medial part of the axillary vein. They drain whole of the upper limb vessels. They drain whole of the upper limb, whole of the upper limb drain into the lateral group or humeral group of lymph nodes. Now is the posterior. It's also called as subscapular lymph nodes. They lie along the subscapular vessel, and they drain from the posterior wall of the upper half of the trunk, posterior part of the neck, and importantly axillary tail of the breast. Next is the central group of lymph nodes. They lie along the axillary pad of fat, and drainage from the, drainage from the lateral, anterior as well as the posterior group of lymph nodes drain into the central group of lymph nodes. Next is the interpectoral lymph nodes. It's also called as the Rotor's lymph nodes. They lie between the pectoralis major and the pectoralis minor muscle, and they also drain some part of the breast, and from here the drainage goes into the central group of lymph nodes as well as the apical group of lymph nodes. Now lastly, the sixth is the apical or the infraclavicular group. This group of lymph nodes, they lie deep to the clavipectoral fascia along the axillary vessels, and they drain the secretions from all the other lymph nodes. They drain into the apical group of lymph nodes, and hence it is also called as the terminal lymph node. It's also called as terminal lymph node. Now the second group of, firstly, the most of the drainage goes into the axillary lymph nodes, as we have already studied, about 75%, and rest is drained into the parasternal or the internal mammary group of lymph nodes. Coming to the lymphatic vessels, there are superficial lymphatic vessels which drain the skin except nipple and areola, deep group of lymphatic vessels which drain the parenchyma of the breast, nipple and areola. And there is something called as subareolar plexus of Sappi, as we see in this figure, subareolar plexus of Sappi. And most of the drainage from here goes into the axillary group of lymph nodes, anterior axillary group of lymph nodes. Now coming to the nerve supply. Breast is supplied by anterior and lateral cutaneous branch of 4th to 6th intercostal nerves. And the secretion of the breast is controlled by hormones. Finally, coming to the development of the breast. We see that the breast develops from what is called as the milk line or the mammary ridge or the line of Schlitz. and this extends from the axilla to the groin. But most part of this milk line disappears by the fourth week of intrauterine life, and only the part over the pectoral region is left behind to form the future mammary gland. The whole breast is derived from both ectoderm and mesoderm. The ectoderm part forms the the parenchyma is derived from the ectoderm, and the stroma is derived from mesoderm. We can see over here the figure for the development of the breast. The part which is left behind over the pectoral region forms the mammary bud, and below the mammary bud there is a solid downward outgrowth of the ectodermal cells. This forms the mammary pit, and below there are 15 to 20 epithelial cords. This epithelial cords becomes tubularized and forms lactiferous ducts, and further forms the alveoli. And so this is how the breast glands are formed from the milk line or milk line of Schlitz. And during puberty, the breast further develops under the effect of the hormone estrogen, and during pregnancy under the effect of the hormone progesterone and prolactin. So thank you guys for watching the video, and for more such videos please follow the YouTube channel White Army. Thank you.